acyl group transfer is the topic of webcast 40. The acyl group is just another way to describe the carbonyl functionality, and so in webcast 40, what we're really talking about is substitution reactions at the indicated bond, at the carbonyl carbon. This is involved in protein biosynthesis. We'll end the webcast by talking about protein biosynthesis and the molecular machinery that's involved, which you can see displayed for you on this slide, along with the PDB codes. There's the ribosome, which is largely ribosomal RNA. You can see the RNA shown in this tan color, and if you look closely, you can see the helical structures that we typically associate with nucleic acids. In green and blue, that's where the proteins are. Also involved are transfer RNAs. These carry the amino acids around. The transfer RNAs are acylated with an amino acid, carboxylic acid functionality, and the acylation reaction takes place by the synthetase enzymes. Here we see, for example, the glutamino transfer RNAs, which carries around glutamine. Notice that the tRNA, colored here in pink, is bound to the protein, the synthetase, which is the enzyme that acylates, or in other words, puts on that carboxylic acid group of the glutamine functionality, the glutamine amino acid. Well, if we're going to be doing a substitution reaction at a carbonyl carbon, what we need to do is to be able to activate carboxylic acids. And that's what I want to talk to you about in this webcast, activation, how nature activates carboxylic acids. Just as a quick reminder, we've learned about this already when we talked about protein synthesis using synthetic chemistry in a flask. The carboxylic acid hydroxyl group is a poor leaving group. It needs to be activated by making that a better leaving group. We've learned about this, for example, with dicyclohexyl carbodiimide in protein in peptide synthesis. That made for a good leaving group. This allows the acyl transfer reaction, or a substitution reaction, at the carbonyl group to take place. A nucleophile will do an additional elimination mechanism, replacing the leaving group. The leaving group is lost. And for example, this is relevant, as I've already mentioned, to protein biosynthesis, and we'll also see some examples of this with the coenzyme acetyl-CoA. All right, there are two ways by which nature activates the carboxylic acid group. So this X could be, for example, the thiol group, and what we have is a thiol ester. Notice it looks just like an ester, except sulfur has replaced oxygen in the normal mode, and these are a nice balance between being relatively stable. They can therefore be in the cell's aqueous environment without hydrolyzing very quickly, yet they do have enough reactivity that they can go on and do additional chemistry. The second way that nature activates the carboxylic acid group, so the X group, might also be this mixed anhydride form that we talked about in the last webcast. This mixed anhydride is an acyl phosphate, and these are quite reactive. They're easily hydrolyzed by water, and so this must be chemistry that takes place in the interior of a protein, an enzyme-active site where water is excluded. Let's talk about that thiol ester group in the remainder of this webcast to see why it differs from the normal ester. And so if we just write the second best resonance contributor, what we have in the case of the thiol ester is a sulfur bearing a positive charge. Compare that to an analogous resonance structure for the normal ester. We have oxygen bearing a positive charge. We know that oxygen carries a positive charge better than sulfur, and so we know that this resonance contributor is more important than the resonance contributor that's shown in this oval. It's not a very important, it's not a major resonance contributor because of the inability of sulfur to carry that positive charge. And as a consequence, we can put this on an energy diagram and show that the thioester is destabilized relative to the ester functionality. That energy of destabilization is what makes the thioester more reactive. Both of them, both ester and thioester, will hydrolyze to carboxylic acid and alcohol and thiol, and basically these are going to be almost equivalent in energy. But the difference is the instability or the lack of stability of that thioester due to resonance. That gives it a larger free energy of change because upon hydrolysis, because of the lack of that resonance contributor. So as a consequence, we can order carbonyl derivatives in their reactivity, the thioester being the most reactive because it has the least important resonance stable resonance contributor, least significant of the resonance contributors. The amide has the most significant resonance contributor, and therefore it's the most stable. And so the order goes amide to ester to thioester, and it correlates inversely with the resonance stability of these different functional groups.